At Moscow in 1980, there was a rivalry between two middle-distance runners that provided the two most avidly awaited races of the entire Games. Britain's Steve Ovett and Sebastian Coe had proved, leading up to the Games, that they were the best in the world at 800 and 1500 meters.
Every time he ran, you know, and I ran, the messages were loud and clear. He'd edge a little bit further forward in the 1500, or I'd run a tasty eight and he'd match it. And of course we knew what each other were doing. And from 1977 onwards, we just knew that inevitably it was all going to come to the boil in Moscow.
The 800 metres came first, an event which favoured Coe. It was Ovett, however, who raced towards the finish and crossed the line for a brilliant victory, unchallenged by his rival.
There are about three or four cardinal sins in that race that, you know, that any one of those would have been enough actually on the day to have buried me.
Ovett's strongest distance, the 1500 metres, followed 6 days later. Many felt it could still go either way, and much depended on Coe's ability to overcome the disappointment of the previous week.
I knew that if I lost contact at any point in those 1500 metre races, that I would be dead and buried, because you couldn't give a guy like Steve Ovett, you know, the thickness of a vest with 200 metres to go, let alone the five or six paces that I did in the 800 metres. And I just had to realise that, you know, that I was really running for my own personal survival.
Coe's blistering finish finally gave him the victory he so craved, and created a happy ending for the two great rivals, each with their gold medal and each with their reputation as the best in the world still intact.